Okay, farming is the main activity in Polambur, and then other several activities such as small scale manufacturing, dairy product, transport, or everything are there in that in a small village of Polambur. So already I said very clearly, Polambur is the imaginary village. That main activity is that farming. So how many families are there? Nearly 450 families are living in this Polambur. And 80 upper caste families are living in that rich families, and nearly 150 families are that Dalit people. They are living at the village, at the corner of village, and they very poor people. They don't have their own land. They are working in that other lands. Okay, so Polambur road is, it's a well connected road. It is connected to the neighboring villages and town. It is Raikanj and big villages in the, it is near 3 kilometers from the Polambur, and then this weather road connected the village Raikanj and further up the nearest town of Shahpur also. So many kind of transport is visible in that road, like bullock cart, tongas, bogas, and why they have to be used these kind of transport means they have to be carry or they loaded with the jackery. Jackery means it is the vellum. It is a commodity purpose. They have to be used to motor vehicle, motorcycle, jeep, tractor and trucks and everything. Okay. This is that the one small village of Polambur. So nearly 450 families belonging to the several different castes, and then 180 upper caste families. They are the majority of that village. They are the house, some of the quite large. It is very rich people. So it is that brick with cement plastering. You see, that means Dalit people living in the one corner of the village, and much smaller house, some of the mud and straw house. And electricity is almost all the people, all the families have the connections of electricity. So this is, it is very useful for the small business as well as irrigation purpose also. And Polambur has two primary schools, that means 1 to 5. And one high school is there, that means up to 12. So there is the primary health center, that means...
And you have to care about kind Dorki Kina.
Who's talking? I do not know.
Ma'am,
health center run by the government, and one private dispensary, whereas the sick people are treated in that hospital. Dispensary means it's a small. And next one is organization of the productions. So the first requirement is land. Land is, we know very well of that is the natural resources. Not only land, we need other natural resources like mining, forest, water, and everything we need when we are set up on industries or business. We need 4 factors. First requirement is that land. Land is important. Generally, we are construct the buildings and everything. Second requirement is the labor. Labor, we know very well of that. What is mean by the labor? Labor means that we have 2 type of labor. What is mean by the labor? Workers. Do the work in particular industries and that is called workers. Okay, 2 type of workers is there. One is that skilled labor, that means highly educated, and second one is manual worker, that means physically they are doing some work, they are carrying the load and everything. So third requirement is the physical capital. Physical capital means they are invested to the business. So invested means 2 type of investment is there. One is that fixed capital. Fixed capital means they are using for the many years. They are using the machineries, tools and everything they are used for the long term. That is called as the fixed capital. Many years means at least 15 years, 10 years they are using for same machineries. They are not shifted or they are not changing time to time. It is it is used for long time. And next one is that working capital. Working capital means what is that? When we are getting order, when we are producing, when we are manufacturing the product, at the time we need some requirement. That is, we need the cash in hand. Cash in hand means money we need, and raw materials we need that. Raw material, it is depends upon the order. Order every word, it can be changed. So that is called as the working capital. Fourth requirement is very, very important. That is the human capital. Human capital means this three factors has to be organized people is called as the human capital. Okay. Are you clear with up to what I thought?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So next we are going to learn the palam forming in the Palampur. So land is fixed. Already we know very well of that land is fixed. Fixed means what is mean by that? It can't be increased or decreased. Only it is fixed. So farming is the main production activity in Palampur. 75% of people who are working depend on the farming for their livelihood. Okay, so they could form the farming labors. Some of the very poor people, they are working in that formal labors, or if they are rich people, they are hire the labor from the other areas. So there is the basic constraint of the rising the farming productions. Land under the cultivation is practically fixed. That means it can't be increased. Land that is already fixed. That is the natural resource. We can't be increased or decreased. And we couldn't increased or decreased. Since 1960, the Palampur has no expansions of the land under the cultivation. That means waste land, they are not recultivated. Only they are using small size of land for the cultivation, sir. So after 1960, they are adopted the 5 years plan. They are adopted the green revolution. Green revolution means that is the 5 years plan. 5 year plans means government, they concentrate much in that particular sectors like agriculture. Agriculture sector means they are providing all the facilities, they are providing loan, and they are given the HYV seeds, the fertilizers, pesticides, everything they are providing, and then they are given the guidance to the agriculture people to improving their or developing their agriculture sector. That is called as the 5 years plan. 5 years plan in the sense they are concentrated only for particular sectors. So green revolution means they concentrate only the agriculture activity. So since 1960, they have no improvement in this agriculture. After adopting the 5 years plan, it is improvised. That means they are recultivated. Recultivated means wasteland has to be started to recultivated. Wasteland la enna pannanga cultivate pandrathukku mari maathnaanga. So by then, some wasteland in the village had been converted to cultivatable land. There exists no further scope to increase the farm production by bringing the new land under the cultivation. Are you clear? Farming in the Palampur, 75% of people depending to that agriculture, that means farming activity. So before 1960, it is not developing. Developing in the sense only they are using small size of land to cultivate it. So no improvise, no development. After 1960, they are adopted 5 years plan. 5 years plan means that is called as the green revolution. Green revolution means government has to be provide all the facilities like tube wells, pesticide, HYV seeds, and they are given the guidance, awareness programs, loan, everything. Every facility has to be provided for the particular sector and improvise the agricultures. That is called as the 5 years plan. After adopted the 5 years plan, first thing is they have to be cultivated the wasteland. They are converted to the cultivatable land. Wasteland enna pannanga, they are cultivatable to the cultivatable land. So there is exist no further scope to increase the farming production. Farming production increase pandrathuke vali illada alavukku they have to be used for all the land. Are you clear in that one?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.